struck.
Hi, I'm Julia Carnese bringing you the campus news. As we all know, Villanova is currently undergoing a transformation in order to update and beautify the campus. Most recently, the walkway from Bartley Hall to Austin Hall was redone, putting in picnic tables and benches, encouraging students to take advantage of the sunny days we all love so much. Over the summer, a field will be constructed in front of Kennedy Hall and the Oriole will find a new home. Many may not realize that Villanova has a significant impact on the surrounding community, especially an economic one. A study reported by the university found that we have a $51 million annual economic and community impact on Radnor Township. Students and other visitors boost the regional economy each year by about $60 million, half of which occurs in Radnor. While Villanova certainly is an asset to the community, the school is hoping to take further steps over the next decade to increase the size of campus and also reduce the burden that local neighborhoods face from students living in the surrounding areas. The Philadelphia Inquirer reported and the Office of the President revealed plans that the school has started a $200 million building project in order to transform the campus and the two parking lots on Lancaster Avenue into new apartment-style dorms in order to bring back about 1,100 students to campus. Part of the reason for the undertaking is because of areas like Central Bryn Mawr that are flooded with students on a daily basis at local hotspots and in the past have caused disruption within the community and neighborhoods. The new dorms and hopefully a fine arts center will draw more students to the school, increase the beauty, and decrease traffic. But are the strict rules for students who are of legal drinking age a turnoff for living on campus? For more campus updates and events, check out the Wildcat newsletter. For Nova News, I'm Julia Carnese. Have a great week.
Hi, I'm Meg Connolly and this is your entertainment news update. Last week, Demi Moore collapsed in her home in LA due to an epileptic seizure. She was hospitalized for anorexia as well as substance abuse of Whippet, a device where users inhale nitrous oxide, also known as laughing gas, from a small metal canister. She looks forward to getting well and is grateful for the support of her family and friends. Singers Nick and Aaron Carter's sister, Leslie Carter, was laid to rest a few days ago after enduring a long battle of mental illness and depression. Sources say that she overdosed, leaving behind her 10-month-old daughter and her husband, Mike Ashton. Approximately 117 million people watched the New York Giants take on the New England Patriots on Super Bowl Sunday. Madonna, Nicki Minaj, MIA, CeeLo Green, and LMFAO performed in the halftime show. There were no wardrobe malfunctions, but the act didn't exactly go off without a hitch. MIA flipped her middle finger to the audience, which failed to be censored on live national television. Madonna concluded her performance with her hit song, Like a Prayer, accompanied by a sparkling array of lights and a ball of smoke in which she disappeared. The 53-year-old won't be losing any sleep over the war of the words. This morning, she announced that she will be launching her first world tour in 3 years this upcoming spring. That's all for today's entertainment segment. I'm Meg Connolly. Have a great day, Villanova.
Hey Wildcats, I'm Nicole Puccio here with your weekend weather update. On Friday, it will be sunny with a high of 46 and a low of 24. On Saturday, it will be partly cloudy with a high of 23 and a low of 20. On Sunday, it will be nice and sunny with a high of 33 and a low of 23. Enjoy your weekend, Wildcats. I'm Nicole Puccio from VTV Nova News.
Hello, Nova. Amid escalating violence in Syria this past week, the United States voiced its lack of confidence in President Bashar Assad. President Obama has finally personally called Assad to step down in order to help end the crisis. With the Arab League's plan vetoed by Russia and China in the United Nations Security Council, it is unclear what the U.S. plans to do next. Because Syria has more connections with countries like Iran, the U.S. is hesitant to intervene with military force and risk destabilizing the entire region. This serves to contrast the U.S. intervention in Libya, a country where rebel forces controlled more territory than the Syrians do. While there is some talk of supplying opposition forces with medical assistance and other materials, the movement is fragmented, and many are worried as to where the materials would eventually end up. Many analysts are debating whether or not this conflict has the potential to turn into a drawn-out affair, ending only with the military ousting of President Assad. This past Monday, President Obama renewed sanctions against the Iranian government in an attempt to force Iran to give up its nuclear program entirely, and that Israel will not launch a military strike against the country. Although Iran claims its nuclear program is peaceful and simply for energy generation, it has yet to convince the rest of the world. President Obama, in a letter to Congress, justified the new sanctions and stated that they are needed, quote, particularly in light of the deceptive practices of the Central Bank of Iran and other Iranian banks, end quote. Also in Washington, the Senate Banking Committee added to this motion by passing even more penalties against the Persian nation. With both the U.S. and the European Union steadfast in their resolve to force Iran to abandon its nuclear program, it is likely that the recent economic sanctions imposed by both groups will have serious consequences for the Iranian economy. Citing the growing instability of his country, Romanian Prime Minister Emil Boc announced the resignation of himself and his government. For months, protesters have been complaining about the harsh austerity measures imposed upon the population in 2010 by Boc's administration. By Romanian law, Parliament has 60 days and two attempts to swear in a new government. If this does not occur, all of Parliament will dissolve and there will be an immediate call for new elections. It is not expected that it will come to a public vote, as the ruling coalition and its supporters have enough votes to secure their victory. During this transition, Justice Minister Catalin Peredu will serve as the interim prime minister. Although opposition leaders to Boc proclaimed his stepping down as a victory for the protesters, Boc stands by that what he did was necessary to stabilize the Romanian economy. For a last story, what do you think The Simpsons and Barbie have in common? Believe it or not, both of their toy figures are illegal in Iran. That's right. Under the pretense that they support Western culture, Iran has added dolls of the popular TV show The Simpsons to a list of banned toys that currently include Barbie dolls. Ironically, dolls of heroes like Superman and Spider-Man have not been banned because, according to the Secretary of Policymaking, Mohammed Hossein Farjou, at the Institute for Intellectual Development of Children and Young Adults, quote, they have helped oppress people and they have a positive stance, end quote. That's all for your world's news, Nova. I'm Nick Ader. Have a great day.